Howdy, I'm Derek, and if you're still living in a world where you're processing expense reports manually or through Excel, you're going to love the Excel template we're going to walk through in this video. Now, before we jump in, if you are processing a lot of expense reports, let's say 50 or more a month, or you have a lot of people who travel every week, this is not the best option for you, okay? If that's the case, you need to look at dedicated expense report solutions that can really streamline the process, automate it, and just make it easier for everybody. But if you're not processing a ton, you're gonna love this, okay? Because this can help quite a bit. So what you're gonna see is more controls to make sure data is captured consistently and accurately, automation with defaults, favorites, and automatic calculations, and a guided approach make it easier to use. So let's jump in. What we're looking at here is a report that's got some lines filled in so you can see what's going on and some of the helpful features that are in play. Now, first off, in column B here, notice the categories that we're capturing. So if you press Alt and a down arrow, you'll see all those categories that have been pre-filled by your admins. So let's put something in place here like parking. Just type a little bit and it's going to show you the options that match that. Okay, so as we go, it's going to show you the different fields that are defaulted if you've elected to set defaults, like the location of Dallas, billable cost center. Those are going to be triggered from your favorites tab. So if you look over here in column L, okay, we've got Dallas, no sales. That's where those came from, okay? And we're gonna look at some of these other default lists and favorites over here in just a bit as we go, but that is what's gonna drive this, okay? Now let's put in a vendor here. Now you can just type something in, or if you wanna, again, leverage those favorites, press Control, Alt, and the down arrow, and we can put something like the parking spot, okay? Now that's a different type of drop-down list because you may wanna enter something new, whereas over here in column B, that's going to be a specific list so that we have consistency. The other thing you're gonna notice very quickly is that we have inline real-time by-line validation. Okay, so it's saying cells C19 and F19 are required. So over here, the date, if we wanna enter something there, we can absolutely do that. Notice that it updates in real-time evaluating all the results based on what validation settings are in place. Okay, let's say this is 7825. Hey, we should be good now. Not so fast, because of that amount, we have to put in a receipt. So cell N19 is telling us that, no, we haven't met that receipt requirement yet. So over here in your lists, you're able to set what the minimum amount is that a receipt is required by category. In my experience, most of those tend to be the same, but you can separate those if you want, calling out things that have maybe more risk, okay? So when we come back over here, now we can add a receipt. Okay, that'll automatically add a sheet that corresponds with that line here. So we're just going to insert a picture, very basic. Okay, so that's for the parking spot there. And now we go back over here and our validation is now met. So we've got this formula in here that actually has a specific count pictures custom function in here looking for an image in that sheet. So it looks like we're good. Now notice that line 6 over here for the meal with Chili's, it has a receipt sheet, but it has no receipt in here. That's why it's showing up as invalid. So if we want to insert one for here as well, we can absolutely do that. There's our Chili's receipt. And we can come back over here and now that one is valid as well. So validation guiding you, that is huge for making sure you don't replicate errors down. I've been using that for quite a while and I love it. Couple other things that we're going to help with this template. Mileage is one of those expenses that can be kind of a pain, right? Now let's put a date for this. Let's say it's the 19th, next day. Got some validation in here making sure that you were typing correctly, which is helpful if you are not as good with a 10 key. Now again, with this multi-use field, we've got a mileage calculator. Now you can enter the whole address or again, save your favorites. I'm always traveling to the parking spot, the airport, you know, particular restaurants. So it may be that you have some of those saved, which is gonna save time. So you can either click those or you can just start typing a couple letters. Use it, take your normal commute off if you need to, and then you can click the button to calculate the mileage. Now this is not bird as a crow flies. This is calculated mileage based on a Google Maps-like API. So if you drove a little bit different, maybe you didn't take the most common route, maybe you had to stop and get gas, you can always overwrite that, right? And then that round trip checkbox is gonna double that calculation in case you went round trip, which is normally the case. So just click or press enter and notice there's the number of miles, there's the mileage amount that's based on your mileage rate over here on your list sheet. Okay, so there's your mileage. And if you messed up, you could always show the field again and notice it's gonna keep those values present, okay, that's stored behind the scenes in case a reviewer wants to justify it or if you need to change something. Okay, so mileage, really, really helpful. Now, we don't need to add a receipt there because mileage is basically justified based on that calculation. And in the same way, we can also support per diems with this. Okay, I am a big fan of per diems because it just is easier to budget, forecast, hold people accountable. Because if you want to spend a lot on meal, great, that's on you. But here's how much we're going to reimburse. So like 50, 60, 70 bucks, right? Now, this is making it helpful because we're doing a real-time call, again, with that same shortcut using the field in column E. We're able to say, what zip code are we using? Okay, so notice I've got Dallas in here as one of my favorites. So enter the zip code, or you could just use one that's stored in a list. You don't have to put the cities in here. I've just done that really because it helps keep track in those favorites. But once you put that in, and let's say it's for 4 days, it's gonna use an API to the GSA rate. So this is the rates that federal employees use. 90 bucks a day there for Los Angeles, 4 days. You can do a reduction if you want to for if you had meals provided, so it reduces that. And then you click enter, and just like with the mileage, you know the daily rate as well as the total that you are claiming. So a lot of helpful features that are gonna make it easier to calculate things. You've got validations and controls in place, etc. So once everything has been put in place and you're comfortable with that total amount that's gonna be reimbursed there, send this to your manager. They'll send it on to the payroll or AP department, whoever is processing these for you, and you're good to go. Everything is nicely organized and they appreciate that. They don't have to redo the math or anything, okay? It's a streamlined approach. Again, if you're using Excel. Now, what the processors will appreciate is the ability to automate the accounting for this. So notice that we use real language here for the category and for the cost center. We're not putting in cryptic codes. Those are all mapped over here in the list sheet. So based on each category, here's an account code, and a lot of times those roll up to kind of a many-to-one relationship, maybe similar with the cost centers over here. Those are going to be used to automate an accounting upload. You can copy and paste this or tweak this if you want. So this is using some of these new fancy dynamic array functions in Excel to automate the process of lookups and filter it down in kind of a pivot table summarized view of this. Notice we only have two rows here, whereas we have nine or so over here on our expenses list. It's gonna aggregate those to keep your books clean. You can always go back into this particular file to see what the details are. So the accounting is easy as well. Now, if you like this, you can get a copy of this template at the link in the comments below, or you can go to excelevate.co. It's the homepage of my website. Just search for expense report, and it should be the top link that opens up there for this particular template. You can download it, and you're good to go. If you like this, please give it a like. If you want to add a comment for some feedback, please do that. Share with a friend. And of course, hit subscribe so you don't miss out on really cool templates and tools just like this one. Thank you so much for watching. Have an excellent rest of your day.